Welcome to our channel. In this video, I'll cover the most frequently asked HPLC and GC interview questions with clear explanations and practical examples. By the end, you'll feel confident tackling those tricky questions and demonstrating your knowledge like a pro. Stay tuned. Hi, everyone. We're excited to let you know that this video is available in multiple languages, including English, Hindi, Indonesian, Spanish, French, Japanese, Portuguese, German, Italian, and more. To watch in your preferred language, simply click on the CC button or go to the settings menu to select from the available options. Enjoy the video and thanks for watching. What is HPLC and how does it work? Answer: HPLC, or high-performance liquid chromatography, is an advanced analytical technique used to separate, identify, and quantify components in a mixture. It works by injecting a liquid sample into a high-pressure system where a mobile phase carries a sample through a stationary phase. As the sample passes through the column, its components separate based on their interactions with the stationary phase. The detector at the end records a signal for each component, allowing identification and quantification. Example: in pharmaceutical labs, HPLC is commonly used to measure drug purity and detect impurities in formulations. Can you explain the difference between isocratic and gradient elution? Answer: in HPLC, isocratic elution uses a constant mobile phase composition throughout the run. It's ideal for simple sample mixtures with closely related retention times. Gradient elution, on the other hand, gradually changes the mobile phase composition during the run. It's useful for complex samples with components that vary significantly in polarity or retention time. Example: in isocratic elution, a 70 to 30 methanol to water ratio may be used throughout the run. In gradient elution, the ratio may start at 30 to 70 and gradually change to 90 to 10 for better separation of late eluting peaks. What are the main components of an HPLC system? Answer: the main components of an HPLC system include the following: solvent reservoir, hold the mobile phase; pump, maintains consistent flow pressure; injector, introduces a sample into the system; column, packed with stationary phase material where separation occurs; detector, identifies and measures the separated compounds; data system, records and analyzes chromatograms for peak identification. Example: in pharmaceutical analysis, a UV detector is commonly used to measure active ingredients in drugs. What are some common detectors used in HPLC? Answer: the most commonly used HPLC detectors are UV visible detector, ideal for compounds that absorb UV light, such as organic molecules; PDA detector, provides full spectrum data for improved peak identification; fluorescence detector, highly sensitive for detecting fluorescent compounds; refractive index detector, suitable for compounds with little or no UV absorbance. Example: for vitamin analysis in food samples, a fluorescence detector is often preferred due to its high sensitivity. How do you select the appropriate mobile phase for HPLC? Answer: selecting the appropriate mobile phase for HPLC involves considering several factors, including the nature of the analytes, the stationary phase, and the desired separation. I typically start by assessing the polarity of the compounds. For example, if I'm working with polar analytes, I might choose a polar solvent like water or methanol. I also consider the pH of the mobile phase, as it can affect the ionization state of the analytes. Additionally, I may perform preliminary tests using different solvent mixtures to determine which combination provides the best resolution and peak shape for my specific application. Ultimately, the goal is to achieve optimal separation while maintaining good reproducibility and sensitivity. What are the key considerations when developing an HPLC method? Answer: focus on sample characteristics, column selection, mobile phase composition, flow rate and temperature, detection method. Example: developing a method for paracetamol in tablet formulations may require AC18 column with a 0.1% formic acid acetonitrile mobile phase. If you observe ghost peaks during HPLC analysis, what steps would you take to resolve it? To resolve ghost peaks, I would first: answer: run blank injections to identify contamination. Flush the system with strong solvents. Replace contaminated vials or mobile phase. Example: if ghost peaks appear in a method for analyzing a drug, cleaning the system and ensuring proper sample preparation can eliminate these unwanted signals. How would you handle a sudden increase in back pressure during HPLC analysis? Answer: point to blockages as the primary reason and suggest stopping the pump and checking for obstructions. Example: in a routine analysis of a complex mixture, if back pressure spikes, replacing the inline filter can often resolve the issue. How do you troubleshoot a baseline noise issue in HPLC? Answer: to troubleshoot baseline noise, I would check for electronic interference, ensure proper grounding, and verify that the mobile phase is free from bubbles. Example, in a method for detecting trace impurities, reducing baseline noise is crucial for accurate quantification. What is retention time and what factors affect it? Answer, retention time is the time taken for a compound to reach the detector. It depends on column type, mobile phase composition, flow rate, and temperature. Example, increasing acetonitrile in the mobile phase shortens retention time in fat-soluble vitamin analysis. How do you prepare samples for HPLC analysis? Answer, sample preparation steps. Filtration. Filter the sample through a 0.22 micrometers or 0.45 micrometers membrane filter to remove particulates. Dilution. Dilute the sample with suitable solvent for better solubility and peak response. pH adjustment. Adjust pH to improve stability and peak shape. Sonication. Use ultrasonic waves to dissolve insoluble components. Centrifugation. For biological samples, centrifugation removes solid residues. Example. For analyzing aspirin in tablets, dissolving the sample in methanol followed by filtration ensures clear injection and accurate results. What are the differences between normal phase and reverse phase chromatography? Answer. Aspect normal phase, reverse phase. Stationary phase, polar nonpolar. Mobile phase, nonpolar polar. Retention behavior, polar compounds retain longer, nonpolar compounds retain longer. Usage suitable for lipids and oils common in pharmaceutical and biological analysis. Example, reverse phase HPLC is widely used for drug analysis due to its versatility and better peak resolution. What are the differences between GC and HPLC? Answer, GC is ideal for analyzing gasoline samples or alcohol content in beverages. HPLC is preferred for testing pharmaceutical tablets, antibiotics, or complex drug formulations. Both techniques are widely used in industries like pharmaceuticals, food testing, and environmental analysis. Aspect GC HPLC. Mobile phase, inert gas liquid. Sample type volatile and thermally stable non-volatile and thermally unstable. Temperature high temperatures, room temperature, or slightly elevated. Speed faster analysis, slower analysis. Best for gases, VOCs, oils, drugs, proteins, biological samples. Here are the detailed key differences between gas chromatography and high-performance liquid chromatography. In summary, GC is best suited for separating volatile and thermally stable compounds using a gaseous mobile phase. HPLC is more versatile and can handle a wider range of compounds, including non-volatile and thermally labeled substances, using a liquid mobile phase. How do you handle and dispose of hazardous waste in the lab? Answer. Segregate waste. Separate organic solvents, acids, and bases. Label containers. Clearly mark hazardous waste containers. Neutralize acids, bases. Safely neutralize before disposal if required. Follow SOPs, adhere to lab safety protocols, and use PPE. Waste disposal services. Coordinate with certified waste disposal agencies. Example, I label use solvents like acetonitrile and methanol and store them in designated containers for disposal. Describe your experience with software used for HPLC data analysis. Answer, I have experience with software like Empower, Chrome Leon, OpenLab. Example, using Empower, I efficiently analyzed peak areas, retention times, and system suitability data. What are the regulatory requirements for HPLC in pharmaceutical analysis? Answer, key requirements include USP, EP, JP guidelines. ICHQ-2 for method validation. 21 CFR Part 11 for electronic records compliance. Example, I ensure all HPLC data follows ICHQ-2 standards during drug stability testing. Can you explain the concept of peak purity in HPLC? Answer, peak purity refers to the assurance a single chromatographic peak represents only one chemical entity and not co-eluting impurities or degradation products. It's often assessed using a diode array detector by comparing UV-Vis spectra across the peak or with mass spectrometry by observing a single mass ion. How do you perform system suitability tests in HPLC? Answer. System suitability tests are performed before sample analysis to ensure the HPLC system is performing adequately. This involves injecting a standard solution multiple times and evaluating parameters like resolution between critical peaks, tailing factor, plate count, and reproducibility of retention times and peak areas against predefined acceptance criteria. How do you perform HPLC method validation? Answer, HPLC method validation involves assessing parameters such as specificity, accuracy, precision, linearity, and robustness. For example, to validate a method for analyzing a pharmaceutical compound, I would prepare standard solutions at various concentrations, run them through the HPLC, and evaluate the linearity by plotting the response against concentration. If the correlation coefficient is greater than 0.99, the method is considered linear and validated for that concentration range. What is system suitability testing in HPLC? Answer: System suitability testing ensures that the HPLC system is functioning correctly before analysis. It includes checks for resolution, repeatability, and baseline stability. For instance, I would run a standard solution of a known compound and confirm a resolution of 1.5 or greater between two closely eluting peaks. If the relative standard deviation of the peak area from multiple injections is less than 2%, the system is deemed suitable for analysis. Key parameters include resolution, theoretical plates, tailing factor, retention time, repeatability. How do you select the appropriate wavelength for UV detection? Answer: Select the wavelength where the analyte absorbs the most light by reviewing its UV vis spectrum to maximize sensitivity. Avoid wavelengths where mobile phase components strongly absorb. Example: Choosing 254 nanometers because a drug shows maximum absorbance at that wavelength. How would you troubleshoot issues related to the pump, injector, column, or detector? Answer: Pump issues. Check for leaks, air bubbles, or degas solvents. Injector issues. Clean or replace injector seals if sample volume inconsistencies occur. Column issues. Flush with strong solvents or replace if peaks tail or broaden. Detector issues. Clean the flow cell and recalibrate the detector. Example: I resolve pressure spikes by flushing the column with methanol to remove salt deposits. How do you identify and resolve ghost peaks in a chromatogram? Answer: Ghost peaks can be identified as unexpected, small peaks in the chromatogram. To resolve them, I would first run a blank sample to check for contamination in the mobile phase. For example, if I observe ghost peaks in the chromatogram of a drug sample, I would run a blank with the same mobile phase. If ghost peaks persist, I would clean the system and ensure proper sample preparation, such as using fresh solvents and properly filtering samples to eliminate any particulate contamination. What steps would you take if you observe low resolution between two peaks? Answer: Adjust mobile phase composition. Increase the organic solvent for better separation. Change column temperature. Increasing temperature can improve peak shape and resolution. Modify flow rate. Reducing flow rate often improves resolution. Select a different column. Using a column with smaller particle size or different phase chemistry can enhance separation. Example: I improve peak resolution between two aspirin impurities by adjusting the acetonitrile ratio in the mobile phase. If your sample shows inconsistent retention times, how would you troubleshoot the issue? Answer: Check mobile phase preparation. Ensure correct solvent ratios and degas the solution. Inspect column conditioning. Re-equilibrate the column after changing mobile phase conditions. Examine pump performance. Ensure stable flow rate and check for leaks. Monitor temperature control. Fluctuations can impact retention times. Example: I resolve retention time drift by stabilizing the column oven temperature at 30 degrees Celsius. What steps would you take if your HPLC system shows high noise in the baseline? Answer: Filter mobile phase and sample. Removes particulate contamination. Replace contaminated solvents. Use fresh solvents to prevent noise. Flush the system. Clean the column, injector, and flow cell. Check detector settings. Ensure wavelength and bandwidth are optimized. Example: I reduce noise by cleaning the flow cell and replace an aged mobile phase. Can you explain a situation where you improved an HPLC method's efficiency or accuracy in your previous role? Answer: In a previous role, we had a method with long run times. By carefully optimizing the gradient elution program and slightly increasing the flow rate, we managed to reduce the analysis time by 20% without compromising the resolution or accuracy of the results. What are the main components of a GC system? Answer: Carrier gas supply provides an inert gas to transport the sample. Injector introduces a sample into the column. Column separates compounds based on boiling points. Detector identifies and quantifies analytes. Data system captures and processes chromatographic data. Example: I use a GCFID system to analyze volatile organic compounds in pharmaceutical samples. What types of detectors are commonly used in GC? Answer: Flame ionization detector, best for detecting hydrocarbons. Thermoconductivity detector, ideal for inorganic gases. Electron capture detector, suitable for halogenated compounds. Mass spectrometer, provides detailed structural information for complex samples. Example, I use an FID for analyzing essential oils due to its high sensitivity to organic compounds. What is the purpose of the carrier gas in GC? Answer, the carrier gas transports the sample through the column. It must be inert to avoid reactions, pure to ensure stable baseline, and reduce noise. Example, I use helium in a GCMS system for optimal peak resolution and sensitivity. How is temperature programming used in GC? Answer, temperature programming involves increasing the oven temperature over time during a GC run. This is used to optimize the separation of complex mixtures containing compounds with a wide range of boiling points. Lower temperatures initially improve resolution of volatile compounds, while higher temperatures elute less volatile components. Example, starting at 50 degrees Celsius and ramping to 250 degrees Celsius can help separate closely eluting compounds in a complex mixture. What is the purpose of a split-splitless injector in GC? Answer, the split-splitless injector controls the amount of sample introduced into the column. The split mode allows only a portion of the sample to enter, reducing overload, while splitless mode introduces the entire sample for trace analysis. Example, for trace analysis of pesticides, a splitless injector ensures maximum sensitivity. If you observe ghost peaks during GC analysis, how would you troubleshoot them? Answer, check blank injections. Identify contamination from solvents or vials. Clean the injector liner and septum. Residual compounds may cause ghost peaks. Use fresh carrier gas in columns. Old supplies may degrade and introduce contaminants. Example, I eliminated ghost peaks by replacing the inlet liner and using freshly prepared solvents. What steps would you take if your GC peaks show poor resolution? Answer, optimize temperature program. Slower temperature ramping improves separation. Reduce carrier gas flow rate. Provides better interaction with the stationary phase. Change column length or film thickness. Longer columns or thicker films enhance resolution. Example, I improve peak separation and fragrance analysis by reducing the flow rate and adjusting the oven temperature. If your detector response is inconsistent, how would you investigate the issue? Answer, check for leaks. Inspect gas lines and connections. Clean detector components. Residue buildup may reduce sensitivity. Calibrate the detector. Ensure proper signal calibration for accurate response. Example, I resolved inconsistent FID response by cleaning the jet and replacing the hydrogen cylinder. What actions would you take if your sample does not elute from the GC column? Answer, verify injection port temperature. Ensure it matches the sample's boiling point. Check column condition. Replace the column if coated with contaminants. Review sample solvent compatibility. Use appropriate solvents for your stationary phase. Example, I resolved a non-eluting sample issue by increasing the injector temperature and cleaning the column inlet.